Root is one of the four output file format supported by the GM4 Analysis Manager. Simply put, a root file can be regarded as a compressed spreadsheet. Columns of the spreadsheet can be read into memory individually. That's why root can handle huge amount of data with ease. In addition to being the definition of a file format, root is also a data analysis tool commonly used by particle physicists. In this tutorial, I'll cover how to install and use root on Ubuntu for GM4 data analysis. Let's go to root.cern and click the install button. Navigate to the Ubuntu section and click precompiled libraries. The instruction on this page is very clear. Let's just follow it step by step. First, click required dependencies. Copy these two lines of command. Paste them to a terminal and hit return. There's an error message saying that there's no package called Python. Google tells me that Ubuntu 20.04 comes with Python 3 pre-installed. Indeed, I can use Python 3 minus V command in my terminal to check which version of Python is already installed. Let's just bring back the old command and remove Python from it. This time it runs just fine. Step 2 is download the release from the desired platform and root version. Choose the latest stable version. Copy the link address of the tarball based on the Ubuntu version on our system. In my case, it is the long-term support version 22.04. Use wget in our terminal to download the file. After downloading, use the tar command to extract files from the tarball. Option X means extract. Z means the file is in gzip format. F simply means that we are going to deal with a file. A folder called root appears in the current directory after extraction. CD into it and list contents of it. Root libraries are in the lib directory. Executables are in the bin directory. Indeed, in the bin directory, we can find the root command. Root config is very similar to GM4 config. It can be used to print out the information about your root installation. If you want to know how to install GM4 on Ubuntu, please click the link at the top right corner of this video. The last step is to source thisroot.sh file in the bin directory to add the root library path into the ld library path environment variable and the root bin directory into the path environment variable. After that, we can run the root command in any directory. To quit from the root interactive session, type .q and return. Don't forget about the dot before q. The command doesn't work without the dot. To source this root.sh file, every time when a new terminal is open, we need to put this line of command in the .bashrc file in our home directory. To see files started with a dot, please don't forget to pass -a option to your ls command. When you are done with your editing, quit this terminal and open a new one for the setup to take effect. Now, let me demonstrate how to use root to analyze GM4 output. I use my universal GM4 application, Gears, to generate a root file. To learn more about Gears, please click the link at the top right corner of this video. Let's go to the tutorials output subdirectory of the Gears folder, where you can find a GM4 macro file, radiate.mac. Run Gears radiate.mac to shoot 2.6 MeV gamma ray to a germanium detector defined in the detector.tg file. After the simulation, you should be able to see a generated root file, gears.root, in the current directory. Use root gears.root to open it, and use the .ls command in the root interactive session to check what's in the file. There is only a tree named t in the file. It records information about GM4 stat points. Tree is just a funny name root uses to call a spreadsheet. The .ls command only works in root. Don't confuse it with the ls command in your terminal. We can use t arrow get entries to find the total number of rows in the spreadsheet, and use show 0 to show the item in each column, the top row. We can use the draw command to draw the statistical distribution of numbers in any column. I keep the name of those variables as short as possible so that I don't have to type a lot in the terminal. If you don't like typing like me, you can also launch a browser called root object browser, where you can simply double click a saved variable to draw its distribution. Meanings of those variables are explained in the Gears webpage. For example, x, y, z are the location of a stat point. PDG tells you what kind of particle is associated to that point. And K is the kinetic energy of that particle at that particular point, so on and so forth. In order to draw multi-dimensional distributions, we need to right-click on the tree name and start a tree viewer, where we can drag and drop different variables to different axes, and click an icon to draw the distribution. The X and Y distribution of stat points reveals that the detector is placed inside a vacuum chamber, and the gamma rays are released from the bottom left corner. I'd like to point out that the draw command in the command line can also be used to achieve the same thing, and in my opinion, it's more convenient than the graphic user interface in case of more complicated analysis. To learn more about the draw command, please visit root's reference guide. You can also find example analysis commands on the Gears webpage, demonstrating how to visualize tracks, find out how many types of particles are involved in the simulation, and what's the energy deposition in the detector, and much more. Many people prefer to use Python for data analysis. There is a Python package called uproot. We can use it to load the root spreadsheet to Python for analysis. The same trick works for Julia as well. To summarize, Root is one of the four official GM4 output file formats. A root file is a compressed binary file, which can contain a lot of data in a small disk space. The root functionality is available in any modern GM4 installation. You don't have to do anything special to enable it. A root file can be analyzed using the root program, which is my personal favorite. It can also be opened through the uproot package in Python or Julia.